Representative Chris Rabb, today we're talking about the budget, or lack thereof. Weeks overdue. I know how frustrated you are. You're ready to get back to work. How is this hurting your community?
Well, there's a great concern that we're not going to be able to pay the bills, which impacts schools, libraries, I mean, you name it. We have a constitutional responsibility as elected officials to pass a budget. Now, we passed the spending part, which was the fun part. Hey, look, this is what we're going to spend money on, $32 billion. And we did so in bipartisan fashion. And we did that by the end of the last fiscal year. But we left out how we're going to pay for all of this stuff. And the problem is the majority party decides the schedule, decides what bills are coming up, decides when we come back to do the work, how long we're on in recess, and they have not figured out internally within their caucuses how they're going to mismanage our funds.
Big question, will school still start on time with this impasse?
I hope so. But in 2015, it was another story. And that impasse lasted many, many months. We can't have a rerun of that show. Nobody wants to see that. We have a responsibility to make sure we pass a fiscally responsible budget. Nothing that I've seen or heard of thus far is remotely fiscally responsible. But again, I need to see it on paper. People are talking. I'm a rank and file member of the minority party, so I'm probably going to be the last to know. Mm-hmm. But that doesn't mean that my frustration is the same as complacency. I'm doing what I can to make sure I get as much information and share that information with members of my community so that we actually have a voice and we can be well informed.
State-related universities also impacted here. We're talking about Temple, Lincoln, Penn State, and Pitt. Why don't you explain how this could negatively impact those institutions?
Well, the reason they're state-related is because they are funded in part by state funds. And without those funds, anyone who receives in-state tuition at a discount, that's where these subsidies help. That's actually where it goes. It's to make sure that these great institutions are made more viable and accessible by the folks with the fewest resources from the state of Pennsylvania, residents of Pennsylvania. And without that money, it's being held up. It puts the universities in a bind, and it makes opportunities for those most vulnerable but most interested in learning and attending college that much harder.